In 1971, Marvin Gaye recorded this album. Which spoke about issues like climate change, racial injustice, and ending America's wars, paving the way for other artists to address these topics for the next 50 years. But back then, Gaye had to risk his entire career to sing about these issues. And in doing so, he brought activism into pop music in ways that had never been done before, with an album that's relevant now more than ever. So how did Marvin Gaye have such an impact? And how did a heartthrob pop singer create what Rolling Stone magazine called the greatest album of all time? What's going on is powerful. I mean, listen. What's going on? The song was about protests, social unrest, the concept of freedom, and a belief that Americans should be able to speak out for what they believed in without having to fear police brutality.
It was deep. Like, I remember it just being really deep, and it connected to me in a way that my teachers couldn't connect to me, or my parents couldn't connect to me as well.
And that's just one song. Let's look at the other tracks. You had Mercy, Mercy Me, which asked, what about this overcrowded land? How much more abuse from man can she stand? Inner City Blues is a powerful song about income inequality and structural racism. Flying High was inspired by the first-hand stories Gaye heard about American GIs returning from Vietnam hooked on heroin. These tracks were specific, and they had impact. And 50 years ago, these topics were not the focus of pop and soul records. This was 1971. Nixon was still in charge, and the Vietnam War was still raging. The civil rights movement was in full swing, but the persecution of black and minority communities was still rampant. The 60s were over, and for a lot of people, the protests and movements of that decade didn't bring about the change that they wanted to see. The mood shifted, and Americans started to get more fed up. Also at this time, Motown was a predominant force in pop music. And this wasn't Motown. Motown up to that point was love songs, incredible, catchy love songs. And throughout the 1960s, Marvin Gaye's music was no different. He was a resident Motown heartthrob, known for his romantic duets. And even though music at large was starting to address controversial issues in the 1960s, thanks to movements like Woodstock, the Motown that Marvin was a part of was not releasing music with an activist message. But Marvin didn't care. He made a decision that he was going to risk his career to write about the world that he saw, because for him, these problems were personal. By the 1970s, there was a lot going on in his life that caused him to be depressed. His closest friend and collaborator, Tammy Terrell, had just lost a horrible battle with cancer. Separately, Marvin's marriage was falling apart, and his brother, whom he was close with, was confined to one of his three tours of Vietnam. Depressed with the state of the world, Marvin had retired from touring and become a recluse, but he did write. After some introspection and writing, Marvin Gaye recorded What's Going On, the song, and brought that song to the head of Motown Records, Berry Gordy. Gordy listened to it and immediately refused to release it. He said he was concerned about getting off track with the Motown brand. But Marvin wouldn't quit. He kept fighting to put the album out, and he kept getting denied. Until in walks Harry Balk, the head of A&R at Motown at the time. Balk had 100,000 copies of the song pressed and released without Gordy's knowledge. They sold out almost instantly. This changed everything. The song became Motown's fastest selling single at the time and rose to number one on the Hot Soul Singles chart. Berry Gordy saw this and begrudgingly made Marvin an offer. He said, "You can do whatever you want with your music if you can record an album in the next 30 days. What happened next was nothing short of a miracle. Marvin Gaye went back into the studio and 10 days later, re-emerged with What's Going On, the entire album. At one point during the recording, Marvin was heard saying the songs weren't coming from him, they were coming from God. The first concept album in R&B history. The songs flowed seamlessly one after the other, telling a story and creating a true representation of the world Marvin Gaye was living in. This album was a massive success. And the inspiration of this album can still be felt today.
Without that, you don't get artists like Kendrick Lamar speaking that real, but still over hip-hop. Or Tupac speaking that real, but still over hip-hop. Or Michael Jackson speaking that real, but over like more pop R&B kind of music.
This is Jords. Jords is a hip-hop artist who writes about the realities of topics like race, mental health, and loss. His song Black and Ready helped raise money and awareness for the Black Curriculum Project in the UK.
He's talking about the environment. He's talking about things like racism, environmental racism, and that is something that still is very prominent today.
Throughout the 60s and 70s, music was incorporated into protests. Different activist groups played different songs at marches. Marvin helped show that different voices have a role to play in shaping these movements. The album's importance can also be felt today in the lyrics alone, and the topics that were covered so beautifully and poetically on that record.
Pretty similar, especially now. It's been happening, and I don't think much has changed. I just think there's a bit more of a circus around it now, and it's getting filmed a lot more as well, which is important, very important.
There are more ways this album had an impact on music as a form of protest. The sounds on What's Going On were fresh, a journey through Gaye's influences with elements of jazz, gospel, spiritual music, and of course, soul.
All the live instrumentation on there is a masterpiece, like the strings. All the strings, like, it blew my mind.
This showed that you didn't have to be a singer-songwriter at Woodstock to speak about real issues. He captured the real voices of his community, which made the entire piece feel relatable and alive. A trend that continues to this very day on countless hip-hop and R&B records. Not to mention the album itself was an act of protest. Artists today have more freedom to create their sounds because of trailblazers like Marvin Gaye. He created timeless anthems about injustice and racism, songs about the brutalities of war and addiction. He sung about respecting and preserving the environment. 50 years later, we're still dealing with the same issues Gaye sang about. It seems as if What's Going On wasn't a question, it was a statement, one that's as powerful as ever.